Assalamualaikum. My name is Nur Zawani Husna Pitakarya. I am a first year student from the School of Education. I am majoring in physics and minoring in chemistry. I am the script writer for this presentation.
Hi, I am Siti Aishwarya Mama Hassan and I am first year student from School of Educational Studies. I am majoring in physics and minoring in mathematics and I am video editor.
Hi everyone, my name is Nur Asrashlah Binti Abdul Rashid. I am first year student from School of Educational Studies, majoring in physics, minoring in mathematics. I am the presenter of this video.
Well, magnetic flow meter, or also known as a magmeter, is an instrument that is used to determine the flow volume of wastewater at sewage plant. A standard magmeter has a sensor, a transmitter, a pipeline, two electromagnetic coils, and two electrodes. As I said before, magmeter is to determine the flow volume of wastewater. Usually, wastewater is conductive due to the ion found in detergent and soap used by the domestic area. The conductive wastewater will flow along the pipeline before entering the magnetic field, produced by 2F electromagnetic coil. Remember, for this law of induction state, the voltage induced across the conductor as it moves at the right angle through a magnetic field is proportional to the velocity of the conductor. In this case, the conductive wastewater acts as the conductor according to the Faraday's law of induction. When a conductive field flows through a magnetic field, it will generate voltage. The voltage generated is proportionally to the velocity of flowing liquid. Okay, back to the situation, the conductive wastewater has a positively and negatively charged ion. They are distributed evenly throughout the conductive wastewater. So, when they pass through the magnetic field, the positively and negatively charged ion are going to get separated. The positively charged ion will attach to the negatively charged electrode, while the negatively charged ion will attach to positively charged electrode. Now, an electrical voltage is induced. This electrical voltage is picked up by the electrode and sent to the transmitter that is connected to the magnetor. The induced voltage is proportional to the velocity of wastewater in the pipe. We can calculate the flow volume of wastewater by using a pipeline cross-sectional area and the velocity of wastewater.
One of the advantages of using magnetic is it is suitable for liquid of different viscosity. The impediment to the movement is nearly non-existent, making this meter suitable for measuring dense mixtures such as a mud, sewage, and wood pulp. Next, they can also measure liquid with extremely low flow. Moreover, magnetic is requires small electrical power, usually around 15 watt to 20 watt, using pulses DC current. However, magnetic do have its own disadvantage. Firstly, magnetic can only work for liquid that have suitable conductivity. Besides, the range of accuracy is very small, which is plus minus 1% for 5% flow rate. Last but not least, magnetic can be a little bit expensive because of the material used. In a conclusion, the magnetic flow meter or magmeter is a viable instrument used in sewage plant to determine the flow volume of wastewater by utilizing.
That's all from me. Thank you.